What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionWriter.com and I'm back with another Oracle Database AT&C tutorial. In this video, we will learn how to connect to your database using HR user through SQL Plus in Oracle Database AT&C. All the Oracle 10G or 11G users must be saying, what's the big deal in connecting with database? Simply write the SQL Plus username forward slash password and hit enter. Software will connect you to your database, right? Let's do one thing. Let's hit the enter key and see if this works with Oracle Database AT&C or not. What? We got an error? Invalid username and password? How could this be possible? Just in the last video, we unlocked the HR user, didn't we? Does that mean Oracle Database AT&C has some sort of bug? Relax, there is no bug. Everything is correct, but not complete. Let me explain it to you. Whenever we write a connection string in Oracle 11J style, like this one, the server starts searching the user with which we are trying to connect to the database inside the container database. For example, here we are trying to connect to our Oracle Database AT&C using HR user. On pressing the enter key, the server starts searching this HR user in our container database. But as we learned in the previous video that in multi-tenant architecture, only the high privilege users like sys and system were placed inside the container database. And other sample schemas such as HR and OE were moved to the default pluggable database, which we created during the installation. Hence, we got this invalid username and password error. Now you must be asking, Manish, how can we solve this error and connect to our database? We can easily solve this error just by telling the server where to find this HR user before it starts searching for it in the container database. We can do that by specifying the corresponding service name of the pluggable database into which our user is placed, along with the username and password in the connection string. For example, in our case, we are trying to connect to our Oracle Database AT&C using HR user, which is placed inside our default pluggable database whose name is ORCLPDB. The corresponding service name for our pluggable database ORCLPDB is also ORCLPDB. We have already learned all this information in the last video. If you haven't watched it, then I suggest you to go and watch it right away. Moving on, now let me show you how to properly connect to your Oracle Database AT&C. For the demonstration, I am using the user HR, which is a sample schema. You can use whatever user you want. The process will remain the same. Great. Now, as I mentioned earlier, that to connect with our database in Oracle AT&C, we need to specify the corresponding service name of the pluggable database into which our user is placed, along with the username and password in the connection string. There are two ways for specifying the service. These are the basic way and through using TNS alias. Let's first see the basic way. It's slightly complicated as you have to go through this hustle every single time you want to connect to your database. Anyways, here we specify the service name through a valid URL. In this URL, we specify the domain name and port number over which our Oracle server is configured. I have configured my Oracle Database AT&C completely on default settings for the demonstration. Thus, the URL for my pluggable database service will look something like this. Localhost is the host name and 1521 is the port number where my operating system is hosting the Oracle AT&C server. And ORCLPDB is the name of the service for my default pluggable database. Your URL may look different. In case you don't know your host name and port number, then you should check the listener.aura file for the information. The location path of the file must be flashing on your screen right now. You can also check the description for the same. Now that we have the URL path for our service, let's write the connection string and try to connect to our database AT&C using HR user. But first, let's get rid of this mess. Let's clear the screen also. Great. Now let's write the connection string. First, write the keyword SQL plus as this will invoke the compiler. Then you have to write the username. followed by a forward slash and then password. In my case, the username as well as the password is HR. Then put at the rate sign. Make sure there should not be a blank space between your password and the at the rate sign. Now specify the URL for your service. That's all you have to do. Now let's press the enter key and see if we can connect to our database this time or not. Voila! We are successfully connected. You can verify it by writing show user. This will show you the username through which you have established a connection. So that's the first way. Now let's see the second method, which is using the TNS alias. First of all, you have to create a TNS alias in the tnsnames.aura file. I have demonstrated how to create a TNS entry in the last video. In the last video, we have created a TNS alias again with the name orclpdb in our tnsnames.aura file. Take a look. As you can see, here in this entry, we have done all the necessary settings. We named this entry on the name of our pluggable database, which is orclpdb, and set the host as localhost and port as 1521. We have also specified the service name orclpdb corresponding to the pluggable database. All the settings have been configured and saved. Now let's come back to our command prompt and see how we can use this TNS entry for connecting to our database. Before we start writing the connection string, let me quickly show you the syntax. Here we are. Connection string will again start with the keyword SQL+, followed by the username and the password, both separated by a forward slash. Then we have at the rate sign, followed by the TNS alias. Hope the syntax is clear to you. Now let's connect to our database using this TNS entry that we have created. Here I have opened a fresh command prompt. Now let's write the connection string. Here you can see I'm using my HR user for establishing a connection with my database. Also, we have replaced the TDS URL location with a simple TNS service name, which is orclpdb. Let's press the enter key and see if we can connect to the database or not. Seems like we have successfully logged onto our database using HR user. Great. So, in nutshell, we can say that in a database management software which is built over multi-tenant architecture like Oracle 12c or 18c, we need to specify the name of the service corresponding to the pluggable database into which the user or say schema is placed. Hope you will find this tutorial helpful. Stay tuned, as in the next tutorial we will see how to connect with the database using SQL Developer. Meanwhile, make sure to give this video a thumbs up and share it with your friends on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe if you haven't already. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionWriter.com.